Oh, you got that shit that I've been looking for. Wake up in the morning, who you cooking for? You my baby, you my good thing. Play with you, we gon' be hooking for. I got some things we can do. I got some things for you. I got a thing for you.
Hi, welcome to my channel. I'm Jor. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. I am so excited. Okay, so I did start my first video not too long ago, so you guys can check it out. Please can you check it out? Hi. Say hi to my son's bear. I figured he had on PJs, like, mwah. And he will be with me while I share my story time. So, anyway, it's story time. All right, so it's the story that I've always, like, not a lot of people know. Let me tell y'all about the day my house caught on fire. I hope that my dad won't be mad at me for telling this story, because not a lot of people know. I don't think my mom know. Maybe I think I did tell my mom, but a couple of people know. Some of my friends. Anyway, y'all. So I was the type of person that was always late. If I wasn't late, I was late. Because there's no such thing as being too late. So once you're late, you're late. So if I was 5 minutes late, hey, can't be too late. Can't be later than what you are. May as well go back to sleep. So, but this day, I just did not want to go to school this day. So it was like, I was just tired. My hair wasn't done. My hair was a mess, okay? My hair was, it was crazy. Trust me. If you see my hair, I was just in a bad mood. I was tired. So I ended up coming up with a plan of not going to school. I thought about it. I dreamt about it. I slept about it. I came up with a master plan. They call it a master plan, okay? So I was like, you know what? I'm going to hide in my closet. And you know what? I thank God I didn't hide in my closet, because I would have been dead. I would have been dead. Because if I had the same thought of me staying in where I was hiding, yeah, I would have been dead, because I would have been too afraid to come out the closet. Now, honestly, I would have been too afraid to come out the closet, but you're going to figure out why. And I don't mean that come out the closet. I mean actually come out the closet, like R. Kelly. Why am I coming out with these weird phrases? My phrases are wrong. I'm sorry, y'all. Like, R. Kelly? Out the closet? Coming out the closet? I'm not R. Kelly, y'all, okay? Anyway, so I ended up wanting to stay in the basement. I ended up wanting to stay in the basement because I knew it was just, I knew I wouldn't get caught, hopefully. So I ended up, my dad, he has like a man cave or whatever. So his man cave is like in the basement. So I ended up acting like I was getting ready for school. So usually me and my brother and my dad, we are either the first three to leave out the home. So I just ended up waking up really, really early, washing, like pretending that I was going to go to school. So I ended up pretending that I would go to school. Washed and everything. Went downstairs. I was like, whatever. I opened the door, like pretended that I left, and slammed the door. And I tiptoed down the basement and I stayed there. So I just had this whole master plan, because I don't know if my dad, he goes in his like little thing. Oh my gosh, telling the story. Like, I hope he's not watching this, because yo. Anyway. So I ended up staying downstairs, and I was like, if he comes downstairs, I'm just gonna hide under, like, he had like a futon. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna hide under the futon or whatever. If he comes, or I'm just gonna have to jump and hide somewhere, just because I really don't want to go to school. My dad was the type of dad, he's on time, he ain't never late, a business or work, like, he just took attendance very seriously. We had these talks. He just takes attendance very seriously, and at the time, so did my mom. If he caught me, like, I was scared, okay? I didn't want him to tell my mom. My mom be drawling, okay? She really be drawling, like. Anyway, so I ended up staying downstairs. So I know how people in my dad home walks. Like, my stepmom, she like drags her feet, like she stumps a little bit. My stepbrothers, they walk a little bit fast. My dad, he like drags his feet a little bit, but he walks a little slow. And my stepbrother, well, the stepbrother same age as me, he kind of got like a quiet footstep type of thing. So I knew everybody's footsteps. So I knew when everybody was leaving. So my dad left out first, I believe, but then my stepbrother. So I was like, all right, cool. So the only person that was waiting out for my stepmom and my two stepbrothers, I ended up waiting for them. So I heard them, but I did not hear the door open and they leave. I didn't hear them leave, I'm sorry. Just trying to hear, like, what was going on up there, like, blah, blah, blah. So I'm like, I'm not going upstairs until I hear that door open, and then I'll go upstairs, because usually I'm the first person home anyway, so it wouldn't look suspicious if I stayed home when they came back from work. I didn't even know why they leave. Next thing you know, I just turned on SpongeBob. I was like, whatever, I'm just gonna watch TV. I'm gonna turn the TV down really low, so just in case nobody don't hear me. I mean, just in case somebody's there, they won't hear me, my bad. So I ended up turning down the TV really, really, really low. And I'm just waiting. Watching my SpongeBob. And next thing you know, I hear this noise. So it was like a, so I'm like, all right, she probably upstairs cooking food. She probably, sometimes my stepmom, she tend to forget stuff. Like, she, like, at the time when I was living there, she always, like, forget, like, the food was in there. But she didn't burn food. She'll just forget, or I don't know, have the thing up. So, anyway, so I'm just ignoring it because I'm so scared to go upstairs. Like, as I don't want my stepmom to know, so my stepmom can tell my dad, and my dad gonna tell my mom. And I, even though I was 15, I was still getting beat, okay? For little things that I did. That was not about to happen to me, okay? So I was so scared to go up. So the detectors is going off or whatever. It's going off. I'm just sitting there through 15 minutes, because SpongeBob, the first episode was about 15 minutes. So I sat down there for 15. Went by. I'm thinking my stepmom's up there burning food. So I'm just like scared to go up there. So I'm like, eventually she's going to come down there and realize that she's burning food. Okay. So I stay down there for another 15 minutes for the last episode. Like, you know how SpongeBob is 15 minutes, a total of 30 minutes. So, and I was like, you know what? I'm going to go upstairs and check and see what's going on. So I went upstairs and I checked and I saw all the smoke. But it wasn't like smoke to the point like, maybe my home was on fire. It was just smoke. It was like smoke. And I'm thinking, maybe she's cooking. But the kitchen is here and the basement door is here. So I can see the kitchen. But I couldn't really see the stove because I'm thinking she's maybe sleeping on the couch or just forget that. I don't know what was going on in my head. I was 15. I was dumb. I ended up going back downstairs because I was so frightened to go back upstairs because I'm thinking my stepmom is home and I don't want my stepmom to tell my dad and my dad to tell my mom. I just didn't want to go do that. And I didn't want to get on punishment. I just didn't want to get in trouble, period. So, next thing you know, I heard someone scream. So I'm down there, and in my head, it rung. Like, maybe my home was on fire. So I'm downstairs still. I'm like praying. I'm like, I hope this is not the home that I'm in. I was just confused. Like, I was downstairs like upset, because I'm still thinking I'm gonna get in trouble. Okay, I'm still thinking I'm gonna get in trouble. I'm not even worried about the home being on fire. I'm worried about me going upstairs and getting in trouble. So I ended up hearing somebody scream in my head that maybe the home is on fire, and I'm thinking my stepmom was up to I heard her scream. So I ended up leaving out the basement, out the door. I ended up calling the fire department, but I believe somebody called first because they came right after. I ended up getting on the bus, getting on the train, because I still had my book bags and everything, and going to school the way I looked. Like, because actually, I actually was running out of a burning home, basically, and no one knew. So I got this call from my dad. He's talking about, did you leave the bumpers on? Like, and he was really upset. So he's like, you left the bumpers on? I was like, if you see my hair that day, you can clearly see that I didn't even attempt to do my hair. That did not attempt to bump, flat iron, anything to, did nothing to my hair. You know, I don't know if it's a condition, but I kind of have this thing where sometimes I kind of think it's my fault. Sometimes I think I forget things. Sometimes I tend to blame myself for things that I have no control of. I started to believe that maybe I was the one that caused this situation to happen. And I know I didn't leave the bumpers on, but then I just came to a conclusion, like, did I leave something on? Did I plug something up? The home caught on fire for a whole different reason. I can't believe I stayed in the freaking home for 20 minutes. I think probably the home had to be on fire for a little while before I knew. Because soon as I heard my stepmom's footsteps. I heard her footsteps a second before that fire thing came on. What I didn't know that my stepmom, she did leave out. So maybe I fell asleep or something, or maybe because I was really tired that day, that's why I didn't go to school. Or maybe I was just so scared that I wasn't really listening the correct way. Who knows? I don't know. So anyway, everyone is safe. So no one got hurt. Not even my dumb self staying in the home and not knowing and waiting, because I didn't want to get in trouble. Y'all don't understand. I just did not want to get in trouble. I did not. And I was downstairs praying, y'all. I was downstairs praying like that. Please, God, don't let this be. If I go upstairs, they upstairs. But everybody was okay, including myself. No one got hurt because no one was home. No one was supposed to be home. But sorry, Dad, if you're watching this. If you didn't know, I was there and I was in your man cave. So I know that's your personal space. But I was there because I didn't want to go to school that day. And, you know, I'm safe. And I thank God. So, guys, like, share, subscribe, and, you know, just follow me on, you know, social media or whatever. And good night. I got some things for you. I got a thing for you. I'll change for you. I'll cut off all the switch the lanes for you. Ooh, yeah. And that got me feeling crazy.